When I was a baby fox cub, my parents asked me if I'd rather have a baby brother or a baby sister. And I said,
I'd rather have a jelly baby.
He's a bank!
Come on, Geezer!
Ah, you join us as we're having a nice, quiet evening in watching the telly.
Is it?
Come on! Come on!
He shoots! He scores!
Shh! Don't wake the baby!
Right, sorry, yeah.
Don't wake the baby!
Now, at this point, we could either explain that young Miss Molly here is only raising a spot of extra cash by doing a bit of babysitting.
Or
we could keep stum and let young Mr. Stephen here once again demonstrate to the watching world what a right royal plum is.
And you are?
I'm Jeff, the little fella's dad. Well, he says he's got my nose.
Which is shortly gonna be flattened by having my fist wrapped around it.
Now, Molly, are you sure you're happy to babysit for us?
Babysit.
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 Oh, Jeff. Let me take your coat. Oh, yes. I can see the resemblance much better from this angle. Very cute. Just like a button. Shut up.
Now, obviously, I'll have my phone turned off while I'm in the cinema, but I will pop out every 2 minutes or so just to check my messages.
Oh, Marion, darling, do stop fussing.
I'm not fussing, Jeffrey, darling.
Ah, coochie, coochie, coo.
Marion, Marion, Jojo sneezed. Now, please.
Oh, I don't know whether this is such a good idea after all.
Oh, honey, baby, Jojo will be absolutely fine. We're only going to the cinema and then for a pizza.
Oh, what are you going to see?
Lunatic babysitters from hell.
Oh, enjoy the pizza.
It's just that I've never left Jojo with anyone before.
Look, I'll feed him, change him, burp him, even repot him if he grows too big. Look, trust me, everything will be fine.
I do trust you, Molly. It's just that I feel like I'm betraying Jojo for a cheap flick and a slice of Luigi's pizza. No, I'm sorry, I just can't go.
Luigi's, you say? Does he still do that incredible double chocolate chip caramel fudge cake?
Come on, Jeff. Let's go.
You see how well I understand the female of the species.
Is he meant to make that noise?
Should I call a plumber?
Babies make me sick. I mean, look at all this stuff that comes with them. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, bet it costs a fortune too.
Yeah. Oi, fat face. Can you take the rest of my lines? I'm off.
I've learned them.
Well, neither have I. See ya.
Oh, that will probably be the concerned parents.
After all, they haven't got all of 5 seconds.
Hi, Jeff.
Well, I don't know what all the fuss is about.
Yeah, exactly. How hard can it be looking after a little BB?
Well, it looks like you're about to find out.
Eh?
Jeff left his coat with his wallet in. I said I'll meet him at the cinema with it. Won't be long. See ya.
Let me take it. I need the exercise.
I should go, really. I am the oldest.
I've got the biggest brush.
My face is wider. Look.
A grown man, well, loosely speaking, and a fox, both gave witness of looking after a little baby for 20-odd minutes.
We are not scared, ha ha.
Petrified, more like. Oh, Molly, you can't leave us with that.
I have to. The script is quite insistent on the point. Something to do with comedy, apparently. Have fun.
Yeah, well, it is only for 20-odd minutes.
Yes, but it's the odd bit that bothers me.
Yeah, but it's only a little baby after all.
Yes, and hopefully we won't hear a squeak out of it. Oh, no. Anything but that. And to think we've just had an official warning about this sort of thing.
Now, for the last time, this... is not funny. Unless you're English or German, in which case it's compulsory. Now, any questions?
Just the one, miss. Would you mind opening the window, please? Boom, boom!
Can't just leave it lying there in... that.
Absolutely. One of us has to go in there and grab the bull surely by the horns, so to speak.
You're right. Are we not men?
Right. Well, technically, I'm a fox. You at least dress like a man.
Apart from Saturday nights.
Shut up. Anyway, I happen to know exactly what a real man would do in a situation like this.
And what's that?
Get a woman to do it for him.
Nicely done, Mr. Stevens.
Okay, guys, I know what the problem is here. The, like, baby needs changing.
You are a blonde genius, Miss Madison. And?
And, like, take it back to the shop and change it for a new one. Preferably for one that doesn't honk as much. Did you keep the receipt?
Do we know any sane women?
No such thing, mate.
We will. That means one of us is going to have to go in there and deal with it.
That's not fair.
What do you mean?
Well, it'll be me, won't it? It's bound to be.
Not necessarily. Let's draw straws for it.
OK.
Looks like you've drawn the short one. Boom, boom.
Hilarious. Not.
Oh, boom.
I'm going in. Changing a nappy can't be that bad.
Like it's up to me.
Evening. Did somebody here call emergency roadside recovery?
Indeed, I did. And a very prompt service, congratulations. I shall look forward to filling in your car.
Thanks. And I couldn't see the vehicle parked in the street. It's not far, is it?
No, not really. It's over there, in fact.
That's not a car.
That's a pram.
Is it? Did you hear that, Mr. Stephen? It's a pram. We've been swindled.
Well, now you've come to mention it, it does look a little bit like a pram. That salesman was very good.
And its pram wheels look absolutely fine.
Oh, yes. Well, when I said it needed a wheel changing, I should... And this is very stupid of me. And I know you'll laugh. I should, in all truth, not have said wheel, but have said... baby.
Ooh. Let me get this absolutely straight. You're telling me you've called Roadside Recovery to change a baby?
It sounds silly when he puts it like that, doesn't it? Just don't break the brush, it's a trademark, you know.
You called the right man for the job. I'm a dab hand with a dirty nappy. I've got three of my own.
What, kids?
No, dirty nappies.
Oh.
Come here, you little tinker. Should that be little stinker? There's nothing to it, really. Ah, it's dead easy once you get the hang of it. Mm-hmm. Oh, dear. Looks like a bit of a pile-up down the road. Poor bloke's been left in charge of triplets for the evening. Nasty.
Nasty.
Night all.
Oh, well, I think we can all bathe in the warm glow of a job well done.
Absolutely.
And it would appear that baby Jojo is also bathing in the warm glow of a job well done. Boom, boom. Proverbial tatty overcoat and worn up.
I'm gonna need therapy.
Still, as the old saying goes, when you've reached rock bottom, or in this case, baby's bottom, the only way is up. Oh, yes, baby Jojo won't give us any more trouble.
Basil!
Sorry? Can't hear you over the blooming baby.
I'll stop it crying.
What are you going to do?
Cheer it up by pulling a cute face at it.
Only one slight flaw in the plan. He doesn't have a cute face.
And, of course, Basil has to get in on the act.
Now, Jojo, I think you'll like this one. What's long and purple? A cucumber holding its breath. Boom, boom! Why don't we simply rock it to sleep?
I know I am.
You might be onto something, Mr. Stephen. Anils, here we come.
Anils? Is that wise?
Look, we can feed him and build up his immune system at the same time. High chair.
Check.
Car seat.
Check.
Bib.
Check.
Bottles.
Check.
Dinner lighter.
Check.
Changing kit.
Check.
Thermonuclear warhead?
Check.
Cuddly toy? Check. And baby wipes, cream, cotton wool, and change of clothes.
Check, check, checkity chair.
Oh, and chess it.
Checkmate.
Well done again, Mr. Stephen. Nice to see you working with me on this episode.
Thanks. But it was one of Dave's lines, actually.
Oh. All right. Pie chips and beans twice.
Check.
Check. And a special kiddie meal for the little baby. Half price.
Ah, oh, that's thoughtful. What is it?
Half a pie, chips and beans. But with a free set of crayons for drawing or pudding. Basil, you might want to go through that list one more time. I think you missed a little something out.
Like what?
Like the baby.
Oops.
Should I call the police?
No. Call an ambulance, mate. We're gonna need it when Molly's finished with us.
We've got to find him.
Okay. Now, look, he can't have gone far.
Right. All we've got to do is search the flat.
And whatever you do, don't panic.
Jojo!
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 Jojo! Echo!
Sorry, love. Wrong episode. Don't mind me. Carry on. Sorry.
It's the baby we're after, not the mummy.
Right. We've looked everywhere. What do we do now?
That's easy. Now we panic.
Right. It's the phone.
How can you tell?
Hello? It's Marin and Jeff. They want to speak to you.
I don't want to speak to them.
It's your show, mate. Now talk your way out of this.
You swine! No, not you, Miriam. Enjoying the film? No, it made you cry. Oh, and scream too. You've been sedated and will be home early. Oh, great.
You're missing Jojo. And so are we. Boom, not boom.
Hi, Basil. Hi, Stephen. How's darling little...
Want to look away now? Oh, get up! I won't do it. I won't do it.
Oh, stop behaving like a baby.
I tell you, I won't.
Let's just hope that I find Jojo before Marion and Jeff find that Jojo is a no-jo. Where's Dave, by the way?
Oh, he used off mysteriously ages ago.
Yes, and he was supposed to be in the whole episode, the skiver.
Baby missing. Dave missing.
And how is little Didums doing?
Oh, the little fa-sol-la-ti-da. I was just singing Baby Jojo a lullaby.
Oh, how is my little darling?
He's in the pink.
I'm in the orange, actually.
Rainy outside, is it? Conveniently. Give me your brollies. And glasses.
We can't see a thing without our glasses.
You don't know how lucky you are.
You can say that again.
Who can say what again?
Give me my glasses back.
Let me just clean them for you first. Sometimes I hate this show.
Let me give my little Jojo a cuddle.
And right now, I have to agree with my fat-faced friend.
And press him to my bosom.
But then again, there is an upside. Press away.
Did you miss your mummy? Did you miss your mummy, Uncle Jojo?
Oh, never! The way you're bouncing me up and down, you think my name was flipping Yo-Yo.
Boom, boom.
Basil.
Oops. Jeff? Jojo can speak! Jojo can speak!
What did he say? What were his first words?
Nav off.
Kids pick up all sorts of stuff from the telly these days. Program makers ought to be more responsible.
And then he said, boo, boo.
That's just stupid. How dare you?
And he, seems to have grown a beard.
I think at this point I throw my toys out of the pram.
Little treasure probably needs winding. Your glasses.
And you're going to be delighted with the deals I've just done to advertise nappies, baby oil, milk, bran, and the new improved thermonuclear warhead. Oh, and don't read the small print. I'll only make you mad.
Oh. Well, thanks, Basil. I do hope baby Jojo wasn't too much trouble.
Oh, no. In fact, half the time you wouldn't have known he was here.
Basil.
Oops. Nope. All up, I will look back on this and say it was an absolute bore. Jeffrey! An absolute bore! Oh, someone please turn those sound effects off!